Everybody, welcome back to the Blazer Puzzle. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNX, and that's Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff.
I'll do. Good to see you, Carl.
Good to be seen.
It's another week. It's snowy weather here in the Northeast, you know?
Chilly. Downright frigid.
Oh, yeah. At least it wasn't Kansas City. Oh, my goodness.
So cold, I saw Frosty the Snowman in the supermarket grocery produce aisle. He was picking his nose. Silence is killer. Silence. All right, bad, Carl. Okay, let's jump into last week's puzzle.
Here we go.
So this one's called To Layout or Not Layout. And Jeff, this was yours. Why don't you tell us about it?
So this came from a problem that I was running into. I'm familiar with working with Razor Pages back in the day and MVC. And when we'd write an HTML page or in Razor Pages or something, and we wanted to take full control of the HTML and the full layout of the page, you could pass in and set layout is null or empty string. And you had full control over the entire page of markup. That was great in those models when I wanted to generate a report. So to show a similar problem here with Blazor and .NET 8, I copied the weather page and I set it up because I wanted to generate a report from the weather page. Drop out all the other markup and give me just the grid that's in the middle. I want to put it on a PDF or something later, right? Make it nice and printable.
No layout, basically.
No layout. Yeah. So we tried this, like you see on line two, layout is null, and it doesn't work.
No, you get a big old error, old screen. It doesn't even run.
What's a good solution to get a report-ready layout from Blazor?
All right, what is it?
Well, it turns out that you kind of have to put your own shim into this. Blazor has all the content in in the new routes.razor and app.razor files so that it knows how to build the page and how to bootstrap and bring in all the JavaScript appropriately, even when you're doing static site rendering. So you need to have a layout page, and what you can do is you can create either an empty layout.razor or no layout.razor. Name it whatever you'd like.
Oh, but so you create a new razor file in layout here.
Yeah.
Razor component. All right. So we'll call it empty layout.
Sure. And you need to inherit from, I believe it's layout component base.
Yep. And then just say body.
That body. Done.
That body. That's it.
Go back over to the report. Instead of saying layout null, say layout empty layout. There we go.
And now that overrides this in routes, which says for every route view, use main layout.
Yep.
Yeah. And now let's see what happens when we hit that report. So we go to weather, and then there's a print report right here. Boom, no layout.
No layout.
Jeff Fritz, you're a genius.
Thank you. Tip your waitstaff and on your way out. Thank you so much. I'll be here on the weekend.
All right.
So we had some successful answers this week, Carl. Who's our big winner?
Absolutely, we did. And the winner from all the correct answers this week is, drumroll please, Diego Giacomelli from Brazil.
Hey, Diego, congratulations.
I love Brazil. They make good meat down there.
They have nice steakhouses.
Yeah, good wine. And good coders. Obviously, Diego is paying attention down in Brazil, and for having his right answer picked at random, Diego's going to get one of these. A Blazor Puzzle coffee mug. And also, he's going to get one of these. A coveted Blazor Puzzle t-shirt. Thanks to our friends at DevExpress. So, yeah, that was a good one, Jeff. I can't wait to see what's next.
Oh, I bet it's only going to get trickier, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, so this is a .NET 8 Blazor web app with the interactive render mode set to WebAssembly and the interactivity location set to global.
Sure.
However, that doesn't really matter. It could be any interactive render mode in any location. The puzzle will be the same for any kind of Blazor web app. So Blazor web apps do not allow you to use the not found section in Routes Razor to handle 404 errors. In other words, when you go to a route that doesn't exist. So this is what we could do in .NET 7. Right? Not found. Mm-hmm. And then we have some custom, you know, markup right there.
Yeah.
And this should work, but it doesn't work in a Blazor web app for .NET 8. Check this out. All right, there we go. So I go to counter. Of course, that works. And I go to counter, blah-de-blah. Oops. That's what we get.
Well, you got a 404.
Yeah, but it's not custom markup, right?
Right. I want to put like the HTTP status cats on there to have a funny cat can't find the cat. Okay, I get it.
Yeah, the GitHub thing, right?
Yeah.
404 not found, wah, wah, play some sad trombones or something like that.
Yeah.
So the question is, how can we achieve custom UI when there's a 404 error or for any non-200 or non-okay error? If you think you know the answer, don't post on social media, please. But instead, send it to me and Jeff at blazorpuzzle@appvnext.com with the subject puzzle number 20. And, you know, hey, you might have to look something up, but you're going to learn something. And you might get a mug or some other great prizes. And, Jeff, we do want people to share when they get the right answer. They want to share your screen and say, hey, I figured it out. Don't tell them how.
Sure.
Right? But share it on social media.
Let folks know that you're watching the Blazor Puzzle. Drop a link to the latest episode that you found some success on, and we'll be happy to hear from you.
Absolutely, we will. And if you win, if you have one, please take a selfie with your mug. Yeah. Share it on social media. Let people know. Because, you know, we got to expand our audience because we need people every week to come in here and, you know, get these answers. I heard somebody sent me an email that says, hey, love the Blazor Puzzle, love watching. I usually know the answers, but I'm too lazy to send in an answer. Are you kidding me? Too lazy?
Come on now.
Don't be like that guy. All right. We'll see you next week. Thanks a lot.
Take care, friends.
Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the.netshow.com for more great content.